All right, y'all. It's time to go through some more with the draft class. We're trying to crank this up, man. But I had to go back to the top a little bit because there's a couple guys I felt that I left out that needed to be there. Jordan Adams is one of those guys. Jordan Adams is a shooting guard from UCLA. He does have hair, and he does not wear a headband. But, hey, you know how we have to do it here. 6'5", 220. Jordan Adams is kind of weird. He's one of those guys who really doesn't really, I think, like look like an athlete, really. But he's a pretty good, decent athlete. Put in 17.4 points a game for UCLA this year. Shot 48.5% from the field, which is really good. Almost 36% from three-point range, and is a very good free-throw shooter. He plays the passing lanes great to pick up steals. As an on-ball defender, I think he has some upside because he has long arms and decent feet. But I think right about now, a lot of his defense is relegated to just trying to play the passing lanes, which, you know, is not that uncommon for some wing players. The jump shot, the stroke on the jump shot is good. I really think that he has a really good opportunity to be a better than average scorer. I think because there was so much talent on the UCLA team this year. Of course, he could come back to school. He's only a sophomore, but there was so much talent on the team this year. I think a few of the guys didn't really get a chance to do everything they could do. Jordan Adams is one. Zach LaVine is another. Had they played with different programs, you might have seen them do, might have saw them do a little bit more than what they did. But nonetheless, I like Jordan Adams a lot. I think he is probably a late first round pick. So that's good. And if he can like impress in workouts and stuff like that in interviews, he could maybe even move a little bit higher than that. You know, just outside of the lottery is totally out of the question for him. Of course, we know this is expected to be a pretty deep draft. Probably doesn't look quite as deep and as good as it once did because a lot of people probably a little bit disappointed with what happened with Jabari Parker and Andrew Wiggins and, you know, Marcus Smart is another one who maybe some people might think had a disappointing season. But, yeah, so that's the deal there. Gave Jordan Adams a lot of dunks, but not a lot of, like, spectacular dunks. The pre-programmed version of this player had a lot of dunks, so I didn't take him out. I just basically gave him the basic kind. So, like I said, we went back a little bit, and some of the guys we had to redo. So, you see some of the people that have already been done in case you missed some of these guys with the A, Bs, and Cs. Kyle Anderson, Thanasis Antetokounmpo. Yes, that is Giannis Antetokounmpo's brother. Keith Appling, Isaiah Austin, Jordan Baczynski, Bogdan Bogdanovic, Jabari Brown, Alec Brown, Markel Brown, Deontay Burton, Clint Capella, Jahi Carson, Willie Cauley-Stein, Samaj Christian, Cameron Clark. Had to redo him. I switched him around a little bit. Gave him this crazy face, which is, I believe this image is modeled after the Czar. I think it is. We had already did Cameron Clark, so just letting you know that we switched him around, so I'm not going to go back over him again. Jordan Clarkson, who officially made it, he just made it official that he is actually going into the draft. Justin Cobbs, we did that. Aaron Craft, we did that. DeAndre Daniels, we did that. Andre Dawkins, same thing. Sam Decker, Cle Anthony Early, Melvin Ejim, Joel Embiid, Tyler Ennis, Dante Exum, CJ Fair. Here's a new one that we just did. Alessandro Gentile, I'm not sure how you pronounce it. He is from Italy. I was really looking for a lot of stuff on him today. Tweeted something about him. He had a highlight reel that was so hilarious. It was like they kept playing the same play like over and over again. And they kept like trying to show it from different angles. I'm like, okay, I get it. I see what he just did. He's probably not as good an athlete as the video was trying to show. Because as I was really looking at that video and a few other ones that had some more extended gameplay, I was kind of noticing that he's one of those guys that moves at in between speed. He's not moving fast, but he's not moving quite as slow as it looks like. So it's kind of like at that you know, kind of lull you to sleep kind of a speed or motion, I should say. He is a pretty good shooter. Shoots 49.7% from two-point range. I actually kind of like the way the EuroLeague breaks down the statistics. It makes it easier, at least from a rating standpoint. Shot 34.6% from three-point range, 79% from the free throw line. What I looked at a lot with him, though, is less a lot of turnovers. 2.5 turnovers a game, especially if you consider he's only playing 23.8 minutes. So that's a lot of turnovers. But what I did notice in almost every video I saw of him, this dude had like mad confidence. He will pull up from anywhere and he totally believes he's going to knock it down. You can just tell by every single video I watched of him. You can see that. Okay rebounder for, you know, a guy 6'7". But I really kind of hit him kind of hard though with the lack of like natural athleticism. He will dunk it. And he will, through, you know, can finish, you know, strong. And I did like the fact that he knows how to use his body when he's going to the basket. He know he has a really good knack for putting his body between the defender and the ball, which is something that's probably a very underrated type of a skill that especially guys who are not explosive athletes have to have. And he does do that well. But aside from that, there was nothing really special about him athletically. So that could be an issue. And he has some parts of some videos are showing him kind of doing some dribbling right in front of guys. And, you know, some of that stuff he was doing, I don't think he'll get away with in the NBA. So that is part of the reason why his rating was not, like, extremely impressive. So that's it for Alessandro Gentile. So let's keep going. Aaron Gordon we did. Jeremy Grant we did. PJ Harrison. AJ Hammonds is a new guy, and I think that AJ Hammonds actually has a chance to be really good in the NBA. And I won't say really good, but good. See, it gave him a 69. He is massive for Purdue. 7 foot, 280 pounds, 7'4 wingspan. This is a big person. Okay, this is a real big person. So there's no question about having the physical strength required, but his hands and his footwork was actually much better than I expected. Down there on the block, he moves pretty well. Averaged 10.8 points a game, 7.4 rebounds, which for a big guy like him, you like to see grabbing more rebounds, but sometimes it works that way. Big time shot blocker, 3.1 blocks per game, 0.4 steals per game. Now, what I did notice, and this is shows it's not necessarily a lot of explosion, but decent. Only shooting 51% from the field. So now you might say, hey, 50% is good. But when you're a big guy like him, especially on a college level, you know you're not taking outside shots. So it's not like bringing his shooting percentage down. This is all right there around the paint, and he's only dropping 51% of that. In college, that's, I don't know. So bruiser, brick wall, and eraser I gave him because he's huge. And imagine a pick being set by AJ Hammonds. That's not going to be pleasant. So, but he only plays about 25 minutes a game. Only played, and then he played 23 as a freshman. So that makes me wonder, I can't give him a ton of, you know, points in terms of stamina because he's not playing that. Never, he's never played that many minutes. But I will give him the credit for the free throw shooting, 70% free throw shooter. So that always helps as a big. But it could be a better rebounder. But what I did give him a little bit of love on is the dunk ratings and dunking close to the basket. He'll catch an alley-oop and pretty much gets off his feet pretty well. So I like AJ Hammonds. I think he would be a good backup center for a team. He could, you know, size, like the old adage is size always rises in the NBA draft. And because he's a 7-footer that moves his feet pretty well, if he does indeed go to the draft, like some people think he will, you could see him really kind of rise into maybe the lower part of the first round. Because right about now, he's probably an early second round, mid second round pick. So, but you could see him take a move up. So that would be actually, it'd be interesting to see. Because anytime you got a big guy like that, you just wonder, the upside is always there. but you don't know if they're going to ever actually make that move. So it'd be interesting to see. Here's his dunks. That's about it. So that is AJ Hammons. So let's see who we got next. We're going to keep cycling through here. Olivier Hanlon. Now, that doesn't look anything like him. I just tell you that right off the top. It doesn't. Olivier Hanlon looks more like Scotty Wilbekin, but I didn't have anybody else that looked like him left. So let's look at Olivier Hanlon from Boston College. This dude is an exciting scorer. He is an exciting scorer. He went for like 41 points in the conference tournament, which really kind of like boosted the stock up. The Boston Globe published an article saying that he was considering leaving early. So he could go back. I don't know, but he's considering averaging 18.5 points a game this year. Shot about 45% from the field, almost 35% from three-point range, 81% from the free throw line. Now, he is 6'4", 185, 190 pounds. He's a thin guy, listed as a point guard. But listed as a point guard, he's not very much of a playmaker, even though he'll throw up the flashy dime here and there, but he's not really a playmaker. His 2.9 assists will show. And he's also averaging about a little over two turnovers per game. So you got to wonder a little bit about the ball security there for him. This is a guy that would probably benefit a lot from going back. But will he? Maybe not, because he has ability to finish at the basket, contorting his body. And off the dribble, he is a handful. This guy can get to the basket. Very quick first step. Just really a good offensive, really good offensive tools. Just got to shine a few things up, get the jump shot a little bit more dependable, and make some better decisions. And I think offensively, he could really, really be a weapon. I don't know how many people got a chance to watch Boston College basketball this year, but there wasn't that much reason to really watch them. But Olivier Hanlon definitely was the biggest reason, because he can score for sure. So I don't know what happens in the NBA. If he wants to be more a more complete player, he could come back to school just for maybe another year, and you know, come out next year. Next year's draft is not going to be nearly as like stacked as this one, or highly regarded as this one. So I could see him being a first round pick, because he may very well be an early second round pick this season. So I don't know. We'll see how that goes. I really wish that I could have at least found a mulatto person to use for him, but instead we got somebody that looks like Bonzi Wells' little cousin or something. I don't know who this is, but that's what we're rolling with. All right, so let's see. Didn't go too crazy with the dunks for him, because there's really no indication that, I mean, he's a good athlete, but not like that. So I got one more new person that I went through this time, but let's see. Montrez, because I thought it was actually Montrell, but it's Montrez Harrell. The L is silent, someone brought to my attention. I would have known that, but I didn't pay attention. Gary Harris did that. The Harrison twins did that. Somebody asked me, will I put some hair on them? Can't edit none of the players on NBA 2K14, so not their faces, so that's why. Rodney Hood did that one. Mohamedou Jatai, they call him Mam Jatai, and that doesn't look anything like him either, so we only gave him a 58. Now, the reason why is because this guy is a really odd prospect. If you read the breakdowns for him and you watch some of the video that's out there, physically he looks like, wow, right? 6'11", 250 pounds, a 7'4 wingspan, right? So now you're probably expecting, oh yeah, and he's a great athlete. Well, it's weird because he moves well, runs well, but when you watch him, there's nothing ever vertically where he explodes. No, you know, he doesn't have great leaping ability at all. And then you look at stuff like, look at his block shots, 0.5 blocks a game, with the French club, and He did block one shot a game playing with you in the Euro Cup, but you don't know where to go with that. But it's he's never really, really blocking a lot of shots either way. And the rebounding is kind of down, even though he's not playing that many minutes. But you just wonder about that and where his explosion is or if he even has it. So that's definitely a concern. But the good things are he has really good touch around the basket with his left and his right hand. You can just see him moving over both shoulders, left and right hand hooks off the glass, and his ability to catch the ball in traffic when on entry passes and keep the ball high, never ever bringing it down the little man land, as I call it, just keeping the ball high and finishing up above his head. I think he has some really nice tools as a scorer close to the basket. But without that explosion, it's going to be a little tough. But it does help him that he's a legit 6'11", and he got arms that just go forever at 7'4" wingspan. So he's interesting. He's an interesting prospect. Now, I gave him the 58. He's only 19. So because he's that young, he has more than enough time to, you know, get things together, especially since everything he needs physically is already there. You know, he's already built like you would want a post player, center or whatever, to be built playing coming into the NBA. So he doesn't have to worry about that. So take a look here at the dunks. Nothing too extravagant. And that's it. So that is this episode of the Draft Class Update, which is number, what are we at, 13 now. This is number 13. And I had already moved through some of these. So Jefferson, I moved through. Nick Johnson, we did. Frank Kaminsky, DeAndre Kane, Sean Kilpatrick, Zach LaVine. Next up is going to be Devin Marble. Okay, so we're going to do that one next. We did James McAdoo, KJ McDaniels, we did. And Doug McDermott, we did. So it's going to be Devin Marble, Jordan McRae from Tennessee. So, of course, that's not finished yet. Vasil Mishic. I don't know where he's from. I got to check where he's from. I can't remember exactly. So that's the third guy. Fourth guy is going to be Eric Moreland, who I almost ended up taking out. He doesn't look anything like that. But I really didn't have anybody else better that I left out. So I let him stay. Then there's Shabazz Napier, one of the hottest names out there right now. See what happens, what we do with him. I have added everybody that's going to be added. So I'll show you a little bit of who's coming for the rest of the draft class. And like I said, I'm trying to work through it as quickly as possible. So Johnny O'Brien is going to be in there. We already took care of Jabari Parker. Lamar Patterson from Pitt. So that's wrong, of course. Adrian Payne, one of my favorite players in college. Michigan State, got him. Alfred Payton. And we got Teron Petway, that's from Nebraska. Dwight Powell from Stanford. He's light-skinned, best we could do, man. Julius Randle, we already did. Javonte Redick. We got Glenn Robinson III. Had to put him in there. Actually, I didn't have him in there at first because there was not a lot leaning saying that he was going to leave. LaQuinton Ross from Ohio State is already declared. Dario Saric, I don't know. I can't remember if I did Dario Saric or not. I look back at some of the other stuff. Not sure I did, but Dario Saric is one of the highest rated international players. We already did Marcus Smart. Russ Ridiculous Smith from Louisville. Nick Stauskas is coming from Michigan. Jarnell Stokes, big beast on the block from Tennessee. Walter Tavares, Xavier Thames or Thames, I'm not sure how he pronounces it. I've heard people do it both ways. San Diego State, Noah Vonleh, we did. Chris Walker from Florida. I think he's going to come out. Even though he barely plays, I think he's going to come out. I think he got some financial things going on. I think he's going to come out. TJ Warren, we haven't done, so don't pay attention to that 81 because I promise you it's not going to be 81. He's coming. Andrew Wiggins, we already did. CJ Wilcox is coming. Chaz Williams from UMass is coming. James Young from Kentucky also is coming. And Patrick Young, Florida. So that's it. That's who's going to be coming. Now, those guys aren't finished yet, you saw. So you kind of got an idea of how many we got left. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11 guys. Let's see. 12, I believe. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, and 26. So I got 26 guys left. So if you figure I'm doing somewhere between five or six every time, if I keep doing six, that means I got four more episodes to go before I'm done with the draft class. So I'm happy about that. So I think I'll do that. I think I'll commit to doing six more, and they'll do six guys per episode. So we'll do four more, and we'll be ready to rock. So not sure if I can get four more done by Monday, which is the end of the tournament, which was my goal. But I think it'll be pretty close. So we'll see. I appreciate y'all watching. Y'all subscribe, follow. Peace.